there in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus was betrayed by Judas, and he was tried as a criminal for his claims to be the Savior of the world, the Christ, the King of Israel. He was mocked and ridiculed, whipped and beaten beyond any recognition. They sentenced him to death by crucifixion. They gave him his cross to bear and to carry all the way up to a hill they called Golgotha. Earlier in Jesus' ministry, he told his disciples that if anyone were to come after him, they must take up their cross daily and follow him. His disciples and everyone listening would have known exactly what Jesus meant. This form of torture, this death penalty, was common in Jesus' day. It was so common that Jesus, when he was crucified, he was crucified between two criminals. There, the Savior of the world, the King, was crucified as a criminal. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12, looking away from all that will distract us and focusing our eyes on Jesus. We are encouraged to move ourselves, shift our gaze and our focus away from the things in the world that can pull us away from him, but to focus our eyes on Jesus, who is the author and perfecter of our faith, the first incentive for our belief, and the one who brings our faith to maturity, who for the joy of accomplishing the goal set before him, endured the cross, disregarding the shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God, revealing his deity, his authority, and the completion of his work. What I want you to see and what the author of Hebrews is telling us here is your frame of reference influences your point of view. Your frame of reference influences your point of view. You see, Jesus was able to endure the pain of the cross because of the joy set before him. That was Jesus' reference, the prize of salvation of mankind. That is why he was able to endure the pain, was for the prize that was set before him. So when he looked at the cross, he didn't see an instrument of torture. He saw a vehicle of grace. When he looked at the nails driving into his hands and into his feet and his blood leaving his body, he didn't see it as his life being taken away, but he saw it as eternal life given to mankind. The author of Hebrews tells us to focus on Jesus. So let me give you your frame of reference that as you endure, as you suffer, as you have to bear even your own cross, here's your frame of reference. The cross is the context. Whatever you're suffering through, whatever season you're in, trial and difficulty, the cross is the proper context for our suffering, for our trials. You may feel like you want to give up. You may feel like your future is uncertain. And when you think about your future, it might fill you with anxiety or stress. You may be disappointed. Can I encourage you today to set your eyes, to focus on Jesus, to put the cross as your context? You see, our suffering, our trials, and even our future put in the context of the cross brings victory. There is there on the cross, Jesus says, "It is finished." There in the context of the cross, you have victory. Rest assured, it is yours. Romans chapter 5 says, "For the sin of this one man, Adam, caused death to rule over many." And that's the reality of mankind. Because of one man's sin, the Bible says we have all sinned. We inherited a sin nature. And because of that, not only sin, but death entered humanity. It was never part of God's plan for us to be separated from him, for us to be inflicted by the wounds and the illnesses and the decay of this world. But it says because of this one man's sin, it caused death to rule over many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and his gift of righteousness. For all who receive it will live in triumph over sin and death through this one man, Jesus Christ. See, the cross is all about God's extravagant love for us. A God that loved us so much, he didn't leave us in our condition of sin and separation. A God that sees you as the apple of his eye, the center of his universe, the love of his life. You see, Easter, this resurrection day, is all about God staying true to His word that says He would come to our rescue, that He would not leave us alone, never leave us nor forsake us. Focus on Jesus. This is your frame of reference, although it may not feel like it sometimes, although even times you may not even see it, it may not look like He is working, but rest assured, there on that cross, Jesus completed it forever. He said, "It is finished."